Today we'll start the second chapter, acid, bases and salt. What is acids? So we'll write the properties of acid, bases. We'll discuss about the salt later on. Then we'll discuss the chemical properties of acids, etc., etc. in this chapter. So what is acid? Acid means it tastes sour. Sour means khatti. Okay? All sour substances are mainly contains acid. It's okay? That means it tastes sour. Then it changes blue litmus to red. Third, you just write down the properties. After that, we will discuss about the acid, what is base, etc. It changes phenolphthalein solution to colorless, that means no reaction with phenolphthalein solution. And with methyl orange indicator, it changes to pink. So actually, what is the definition of acid, I will tell you. But these are the physical parts, you have to remember. Acid mainly, in ancient time, the scientists are saying that the acids are which are taste sour, okay? But later on, another indicator, that is blue litmus solution, that which changes to red in acid. With phenolphthalein, it is colorless, and also with acid environment, it is also colorless. Then final one, that is methyl orange, it changes to pink in color. Initially it is orange in color, it changes to pink in color. It's okay? So this is all about the acid. Similarly, bases, it tastes bitter. Just reverse, it tastes bitter. Second one, changes red litmus to blue. The third one, with phenolphthalein, solution, pink, and final one, methyl orange, it changes to yellow. It means these two are synthetic indicators, you have to remember these two. Phenolphthalein means in acid it is colorless, no change in color, but phenolphthalein with base it is pink in color. Methyl orange with acid it changes to pink, but methyl orange with base it changes to yellow. Now we'll discuss actually what is an acid. So all acids, mainly in all citrus fruit, vinegar, mainly these are sour in taste. These things mainly containing acids. That means acids are mainly sour in taste. And bases means these are bitter in taste. It's okay? But modern theory or modern definition, that is Arrhenius theory. What is acid? Acids are proton donor. Acids are mainly proton donor because, you just write on your copy, acids are proton donor. That means in their aqueous solution, they liberate H plus ion. Therefore, they are known as proton donor. Any acid if you take, HCl or H2SO4 or HNO3, these are all inorganic acids or strong acids. In aqueous solution, it liberates H plus ion, Cl minus ion. It liberates H plus ion. Two number of H plus ions, this will liberate SO4 2 minus ion. If HNO3 means same thing, H plus ion, NO3 minus ion, it's okay? That means All acids are proton donor. That means they liberate H plus ion. You know H plus ion is a proton? You just remember hydrogen means it has one proton and one electron. If it loses that one electron, then it will be H plus ion. So all acids are proton donor. You just remember this line. Similarly, all bases, these are proton acceptor. That means what? In base, let's say I'm giving you some example, KOH, potassium hydroxide, or NH4OH, or CuOH whole 2. It's okay? Number of bases are there, or MgOH whole 2, magnesium hydroxide, that is milk of magnesia you are taking as antacid. So all bases, you know that they liberate OH minus ion. But I am saying you that bases are proton acceptor. Means what? As bases in the aqueous solution liberate OH minus ion, this OH minus ion combined with H plus ion produce water. It means what? All acids are proton donor. Similarly, all bases are proton acceptor. Means liberate OH minus ion combined with H plus ion produce water. So later on we'll discuss acid plus base gives salt and water. It's okay? Now we'll discuss some strong acids and weak acids, then strong bases and weak bases. Okay? Then we'll enter into the book. Okay? First, strong acid. The definitions you can write. The acids which completely get dissociated into ions in their aqueous solution, they are known as strong acids. They completely get dissociated into ions means they completely get ionized. It's okay? So the acids which get completely ionized, they are known as strong acids. Example, all mineral acids, HCl, H2SO4, HNO3, these are all known as mineral acids, means they form mineral salts. So all mineral acids are strong acids. Similarly, weak acids, mainly all organic acids, and inorganic, in between inorganic acid, one is H2CO3, carbonic acids, we are taking in cold drinks, okay? Carbonic acid, sulfurous acid, acetic acid. Similarly, various organic acids are there, palmitic, citric, etc., etc., tartaric. Okay? So these are all weak acids. What is weak acid? The acids which partially get dissociated into ions is known as weak acid. It's okay? Partially get dissociated into ion means in their aqueous solution, practically MCQ questions will come like this. Okay? One question will come in practical MCQ. Weak acid means they partially get dissociated into ions. That means in the aqueous solution, ions are there as well as these acids are also exist. That means some portion of the acids will get dissociated and some acids will remain in the solution. Those are known as weak acids. Similarly, strong base. Same thing, the bases which completely get dissociated into ions, those are known as strong base. Strong base means mainly high reactive metal oxides, they form strong base with water. That means they are hydroxides. High reactive metal means sodium, potassium, calcium, magnesium, like this. But magnesium is not your strong. Okay? Sodium, potassium, calcium. Okay? In reactivity series, first potassium, then sodium, then calcium. That means potassium hydroxide, sodium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide. These are strong bases. Similarly, weak base, rest are, that means magnesium, hydroxide, copper, hydroxide, like this, in the reactivity series, the metal hydroxides, Another one I am telling you, that is ammonium hydroxide. So these are weak bases. The second part, acid bases in your laboratory, that means with phenolphthalein solution, what change? With methyl orange, what change? Okay? But one important question is there, what is olfactory indicator? That thing I have telling you about the synthetic indicator. What is olfactory indicators? Olfactory indicator means the substance which changes its odor or color in presence of acid or base is known as olfactory indicator. Example, vanilla essence. Vanilla essence has a sweet smell using in cake. It changes its color. Onion peels, rose, turmeric powder. These are the example of olfactory indicator. It's okay?